Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm Britt, creator of the Style Shaker, your guide to green and clean beauty, and I am holding these mascaras because today I'm going to be doing a face-off comparing the most recent purchases, which are the Elate mascara, Saphho mascara, and the new Clove Hallow mascara. So I'm gonna pit these against each other. There's gonna be a battle. It might get ugly. I don't know. I might end up with really great lashes. Either way, it's coming up, so stick around and let's get into it.
Quick heads up, if you're going from toxic to non-toxic and have no clue where to start, check out my free green beauty guide back on the website. It's the one pager I wish I had when I first started out. In the meantime, don't forget to like this video and make sure you subscribe so you never miss another one.
Okay, so first off, still trying to figure out lighting in the new space. Bear with me. Don't know what's going on, but making it work. So I'm gonna talk through each of these and then compare them to one another with just a few quick sound bites and give you my final verdict and also the scorecard score. First question on the scorecard is always about ingredients. So none of these gave me any cause for concern, or I didn't see any major red flags on ingredients across all of them. I am starting to post quick scorecard reviews on my Instagram channel. It's just easier, quicker, you don't have to wait for a video. So if you want to see any of those, the Saphho one at the time of recording is up. These will also be up. I'll put links to all of that for you so you can find it quickly. And I do want to ask you a quick question. What is your favorite mascara right now? Leave it in the comment section below. I love hearing from you all. There's such great responses from this community, and it's really, really helpful to everybody else that's watching. What's your favorite mascara and why? First question, ingredients. I didn't freak out. So I'm going to start with the Elate. Elate mascara is $28 and it got an overall score on the scorecard of 25 out of 30. Pretty respectable score. This mascara was great. I love the packaging. There's still plastic involved here, but the brand is doing really amazing things for sustainability. Not perfect, but closer than a lot of others, which I appreciate. I would say this offers a more natural, to me it gave more of a feathered look on the lashes, which I like, but it was a natural feathered look. Still imparted a little bit of impact. So you know it's there. It's not the natural kind of mascara that you put on and you just look like slightly enhanced with your lashes. You could actually tell that this was doing something. It did build well on top of the first coat and it did last throughout the day. However, I did see a little bit of flaking. I know a primer would help that, but I didn't want to use that for this to make it a fair assessment of the mascara. This, in terms of volumizing and lengthening, those are the two big things that we're always looking for when it comes to mascara. This hit on each of those evenly. It wasn't a huge knock it out of the park for the volumizing and multiplying, and it wasn't that for lengthening, but it did achieve a really great, more feathered, natural look. Overall, it was a solid performer. The next is Saphho. This is the most expensive of the three. It is at $34. It also got a 25 out of 30 on the scorecard, so did really well. This little mascara, I gotta tell you. So I got it from Integrity Botanicals. I got it as a bonus and it has a rubber brush. Usually in the past, rubber brushes, I haven't seen the best results for my lashes. A very flexible brush. You could tell it just moves really, really easily. It held the curl very well. So I know that people always ask that question, like, didn't hold the curl for me. Does it hold the curl for you? Is it gonna hold the curl? For me, it held the curl very well. The first coat I thought, okay, wow, this is surprising for a rubber brush, but it's kind of getting there. It wasn't like, whoa, this is amazing. Then I gave it a second and I applied the next layer and I did just the wiggle. Instead of just the coating like this, like the straight up and down north-south thing, I did the east-west. I did the east-west lash wiggle. I don't know where that terminology came from, but you guys know what I mean. It deposited more product and it really built very, very well. So I also wanted to say great for building up and giving you more of an impact there. I would say that this gave more on volumizing, not necessarily multiplying. It really built up those lashes. I would say for lengthening, it did a great job. It just wasn't the most standout quality. A bit more for volumizing than lengthening. This did not flake off or fall or smudge throughout the day on me, and I didn't have a primer on. I also wanna say I wear contacts, and if you see me tearing, it's because I've had like crazy allergies here. I just moved here. I'm not used to it. I'm used to being on the ocean It's like no allergies. I did not have any irritation from any of the mascaras that I'm talking about, and it didn't affect my contacts, which is important to know if you have sensitive eyes and you're sensitive to that. Last one is Clove Hallow. This is their new FlexLash Mascara. Giant brush, tiny little wand. This mascara is $19 and it received a 19 out of 30 on the scorecard. I don't have much to say about this except that it was a very wet formula for me. It fell short on volumizing, and I would say it lengthened a very small amount, but not enough in my opinion, just for my lashes. I did receive information from my community. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So helpful. The owner said if you give it a week, it'll thicken up and be less liquidy, which is great to know, but like a part of me wonders, like, why does that have to be a part of this whole product description? They're like, shouldn't it just be good off the bat? I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Whatever. If you're worried about this and you have it, and you're like, it's too watery, give it a week, evidently. That's supposed to help. It was just overall kind of a bit of a bummer, and the packaging, you know, they're all over the ingredients, which I absolutely appreciate, but in terms of looking forward and sustainability, I didn't get that from them or their website or any of the information that they post on their product pages, so it's kind of the least sustainably focused from the information that I saw out there out of the three mascaras. That's all I have to say about that one. That was kind of a letdown, if you couldn't tell. Here's my final verdict for all these and who I think each would be best for, where you should potentially spend and where you should probably pass. Clove Hallow, if you couldn't tell, I don't think it's worth it. I know it's the least expensive of the bunch, but for me, the performance just wasn't there. I wasn't a big fan. I wouldn't recommend it. I do like a lot of other Clove Hallow products. I've reviewed them on the channel, so I'm a fan of the brand. It's just the mascara fell short for me. The Saphho. All right, so if you're looking for something that holds curl, I would look in this direction out of these three. Keep in mind, I've reviewed other mascaras, so you might want to check out my favorites page. I will put a link below. It's not fully up to date, but I'm going to be putting out a whole new quarterly update for that. But still, I think that would be helpful for you to know if you narrow it down to one on this video. And you want to keep looking at others, you can check out that favorites page. But if you're looking to hold a curl, this is great. It is the most expensive of this group, and it is up there when it comes to price in the category overall. So you have to be okay with spending that, which I know is a very personal thing. I would recommend this to a friend. I would use it again. I would repurchase it. This is probably my number one pick of the bunch. I just really, really like it. And oddly enough, it was the one that I got for free with purchase. Well, I got a gift with purchase. And then the Elate Mascara. So this is the middle road in terms of budget. I think if you're looking for a more natural, still impactful though. It's not that like wimpy natural look, do you know what I mean? If you're looking for a more natural, still impactful look, and you're really going for ultimate sustainability, and you care about having the volume and the lengthening, you just want them to be solid on both, you're not looking for one over the other, then the Elate Mascara would be fantastic for you. I would absolutely recommend this. I liked this mascara quite a bit. I really like the company a lot. The more I try from them, the more I like. It's just that Saphho won me out when it came to the building on top of the first layer. I just really liked what it did, and it didn't flake as much, or it didn't smudge as much throughout the day. Actually, it didn't at all. This did very, very teeny tiny bit. So there is a very narrow margin between these two. Why do I keep saying very? I don't know. That's really all I have for the three of these mascaras. These are the ones that are new to me that I tried out this week. They will be added into the larger favorites group if they make the cut against my other favorites. So that's to come a little bit later. But for now, hopefully you've gotten enough information to know whether you want to try it or whether you do not want to buy it. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel and give this video a thumbs up to support the channel. It really, really does help. I'm going to go test something else now. So I will see you guys right back here real soon. Until then, bye. Whatever. I don't need to say that. Ugh. Leaning in. Blah, 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 blah.